ಸದಾ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ಅನುಸ್ಮರಂತಃ ರಾತ್ರೌ ಚ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ಪುನರುತ್ಥಿತಾಯಿ ತೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ದೇಹ ಪ್ರವಿಶಂತಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ಆಜ್ಯಂ ಯಥಾ ಮಂತ್ರಹುತಂ ಹುತಾಶೇ ಬುದ್ಧಿರ್ಬಲಂ ಯಶೋ ಧೈರ್ಯಂ ನಿರ್ಭಯತ್ವಮರೋಗತಾ ಅಜಾಢ್ಯಂ ವಾಕ್ಪಡುತ್ವಂ ಚ ಹನುಮತ್ ಸ್ಮರಣಾತ್ ಭವೇತ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಸ್ಕಂದ ಆಫ್ ದ ಭಾಗವತ. ಪ್ರಸಾದಾಭಿಮುಖಂ ಶಶ್ವತ್ ಪ್ರಸನ್ನವದನೆ ಕ್ಷಣಂ ಸುನಾಸಂ ಸುಬ್ರುವಂ ಚಾರುಕಪೋಲಂ ಸುರಸುಂದರಂ ತರುಣಂ ರಮಣೀಯಾಂಗಂ ಅರುಣೋಷ್ಠೇ ಕ್ಷಣಾಧರಂ ಪ್ರಣತಾಶ್ರಯಣಂ ನೃಣಂ ಶರಣ್ಯಂ ಕರುಣಾರ್ಣವಂ ತ್ರಿವತ್ಸಾಂಕಂ ಘನಶ್ಯಾಮಂ ಪುರುಷಂ ವನಮಾಲಿರಂ ಶಂಖಚಕ್ರಗದಾ ಪದ್ಮೈಃ ಅಭಿವ್ಯಕ್ತ ಚತುರ್ಭುಜಂ ಕಿರೀಟಿನಂ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಂ ಕೇಯೂರವಲಯಾನ್ವಿತಂ ಕೌಸ್ತುಭಾಭರಣಗ್ರೀವಂ ಪೀತಕೌಶೇಯವಾಸಸಂ ಕಾಂಕ್ಷೀಕಲಾಪರ್ಯಸ್ತಂ ಲಸತ್ಕಾಂಚನನೂಪುರಂ ದರ್ಶನೀಯತಮಂ ಶಾಂತಂ ಮನೋನಯನವರ್ಧನಂ ಪದ್ಭ್ಯಾಂ ನಖಮಣಿಶ್ರೇಣ್ಯಾ ವಿಲಸದ್ಭ್ಯಾಂ ಸಮರ್ಚತಾಂ ಋಕ್ಪದ್ಮಕರ್ಣಿಕಾನಿಷ್ಣ್ಯಂ ಆಕ್ರಮ್ಯಾತ್ಮನೆ ಅವಸ್ಥಿತಂ ಸ್ಮಯಮಾನಂ ಅಭಿಧ್ಯಾಯೇ ಸಾನುರಾಧಾವಲೋಕನಂ ಏವಂ ಭಗವತೋ ರೂಪಂ ಸುಭದ್ರಂ ಧ್ಯಾಯತೋ ಮನಃ ನಿರ್ವೃತ್ಯಾ ಪರಯಾ ತೂರ್ಣಂ ಸಂಪನ್ನಂ ನ ನಿವರ್ತತೆ ಜಪ್ಯಶ್ಚ ಪರಮೋ ಗುಹ್ಯಃ ಶೂಯತಾಂ ಮೇ ನೃಪಾತ್ಮಜ ಯಂ ಸಪ್ತರಾತ್ರಂ ಪ್ರಪಟನ್ ಪುಮಾನ್ ಪಶ್ಯತಿ ಖೇಚರಾನ್. ವಾಸುದೇವಾಯ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮಂತ್ರ. ದಿಸ್ ಮಂತ್ರ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್. ದ ರೆಸ್ಪ್ಲೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಡ್, ಕ್ರೌನ್, ತಿಲಕ, ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಇಯರಿಂಗ್ಸ್, chiseled nose, chiseled chin, lovely cheeks, smiling lips, vishala vakshatala, a curl of hair called Srivatsa, Kaustubha is the huge pendant the Lord is wearing, epaulets, which is Kayura, got Kankana, rings, he's got radiant nails, got anklets, bracelets, and two lovely pitambaras. As the child takes in this beautiful form of the Lord, goes round Naradri three times and bows down. He goes and has a bath, as he was asked to have a bath, and starts the tapasya. Tapasya should be done little by little. Have I not told you, on January 1st, all of us make very great resolutions. By January 5th, they are gone. Because we are weaklings. The mind is not strong. Ye karna hai, wo karna hai, idu pannu, nothing happens. Little by little. Some people say, I must bring down my weight. I must go for a 5-kilometer walk and finally land up with knee problem. No? That's not the way to overexert the body. Shanai shanai uparavet. The Gita says, do it slowly, slowly. First month, once in 3 days, he had wood apple. In the second month, once in 6 days, he had grass. Then, third month, once in 9 days, he had water. Fourth month, once in 12 days, Dwadashe, Dwadashe Ahani, Vayu Bhaksho. He breathed in air. The fifth month, he stood on one foot. Dhruva means the steady one. Dhruva means the unchangeable one. Dhruva means the unshaken, unshakable one. For 5 months, he's standing, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. The microcosm, macrocosm is affected. Is breathlessness in the air. All the gods go and tell, Narayana, Narayana, we are breathless. He says, don't worry, elementary. That little child has communed with me. Is it elementary? To control the macrocosm in your heart, is it elementary? After thousands of births, you can control the Lord in your heart. At once, my master Dikshit is to make fun. At once the Lord asked, Naraji, describe me. Naraji says, kya ho gaya aapko? What's the problem? He said, please describe me. The child has concentrated on my figure with such perspicacity. Even if one kundala is missing, he will say, Xerox copy, not original. So again the Lord's description is given. The Lord sits before the dressing table, dresses himself beautifully and appears before Dhruva. Dhruva in the middle of the forest is chanting Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. The Lord wants to test you. The Lord loves to play with his devotees. Hare Krishna. How he plays with his devotees, how he teases them. He deletes that image of his. In the heart of Dhruva, there is the Vishnu Swarupa. He deletes it. Lord Narayana is playing with Dhruva. He deletes that picture of Narayana in the heart of Dhruva. The child opens his eyes, oh God, where is he gone? He is speechless. When you and I stand before Balaji, the oldest shloka we know is forgotten. Krishnaya Vasudeva is forgotten. Vinamagadesham is forgotten. Imagine seeing the actual Lord. The poor child is speechless. The Lord is looking at him. You want to praise me? He takes the Shankha and touches his cheek. Shankha is Jnana Pradayaka. That is why in the Bhagavad Gita, first the Lord gave Shankanada and then Gita. Panchajanyam Rishikeshu Devadittam Dharanjayaha. That is how the Shankha Sparsha. The moment he touches the cheek of Dhruji, you find the child begins to speak. My dear listeners, what do I want to convey? Bhagwan ke bare mein bolne ke liye Bhagwan ki kripa chahiye. This is not naukri.com. This is not a job. It's a mission. And when it's a mission, it is to be inspired by the Lord. The child is now inspired by the Lord. And what does he say? With humility, I tell you, even the healthiest man can have a stroke. The healthiest man can have a heart attack. Anything can happen. You say, oh, I go to the gym every day. I go for a morning walk. Anything can happen. And when we run an Ayurvedic hospital, so I know what it is. When a man has a stroke, he can't even hold a cup of coffee or a tea. What does it mean? Rishikesha, who is the Lord presiding over this limb, has taken leave. You need Narayana's grace to be healthy. In order to be healthy, you need his grace. The child is not asking Narayana for his father's love. He is not asking Narayana for his mother's love. He is not asking Narayana for the entire property which belongs to his father. No. He is asking the Lord, may I have your grace, Master. May I have your grace. You enter in my entire sense organs. You enter my body and give me the power, give me the eyes, the power to see, the ear, the power to listen, the skin, the power to touch, the limbs, the power to move. What a lovely prayer. My dear listeners, fold your hands. I am chanting this shloka for your good health. Yonta pravishyam avacham imam prasuptam sanjeevayat akila shakti dharasvadhamna anyantahatta charana shravanatvagadim pranam namo bhagavate purushayatubhyam purushayatubhyam. Fourth canto, ninth chapter, sixth shloka of the Bhagavatam, 496. If you have the text of the Bhagavatam, ghar jaake padh lijiye. You are the one who enters and makes my entire body vibrant with life. This is a miracle shloka. A shloka which makes almost a dying man come back alive and chant the name of the Lord. Fourth canto, ninth chapter, sixth shloka. Yonta pravishya mama vacham imam prasuptam sanjeevayat akila shakti dharasvadhamna anyamta hatta charana shravanatvagadim pranam namo bhagavate purushaya tubhyam. Dhruva listens to the Lord's blessing, goes back to Ruri. At five, if he was given liberation, none of us would go to the Lord. According to Hinduism, you enjoy all the dharmic joys of life. Dharma viruddha bhuteshu tamosmi bharatarshava. I tell youngsters, don't think you have to go straight to moksha at 25. No. You start your sadhana early. The phala will be at 85, 95. Doesn't matter. But throughout you will have the blessing of the Lord. The child is made to rule. What is most moving about this incident is when he meets his stepmother, he bows down to her.
The woman who sent him to the forest, never bear hatred. I always feel the most unpleasant circumstance makes me a better person. I used to ask Akhandanji Maharaj of Vrindavan, "Achhe logon ko dukh kyun hota hai?" He said, "Mataji, sone ko hi tapate hain. It is sona, it is gold." We have a trustee called Sunil Bhai who runs a gold factory in Dubai. And I found they put gold into a furnace which is burning red. And I looked into the furnace, it's burning. I said, "This is how the Mahatma is made. This is how the great man is made, burning, burning, burning." That is how he comes out of it, whether it is Mirabai, whether it is Kabir, whether it is Annamacharya, whether it is Tukaram or Janabai, whoever it is. All the great ones of the world have suffered and come out of it. The Bhagavata says, never bear hatred. Sri Rama comes back in the Valmiki Ramayana after 14 years of exile and bows down to Kaikeyi. Against the law of primogeniture, he was sent into the forest. Against the law of primogeniture. I hope you know that much of law. Unless a man commits a crime or he is demented, he should not be deprived of his father's legacy. These are the two disqualifications for him. And Sri Rama is of spotless character, sterling character. Srinivas Shastri called him staggering perfection. That is how he was. Not a single fault in my Lord Rama. Such a Lord was sent into the forest by Kaikeyi. He bows down to her. He bears no hatred. When on Chitrakuta, you have Bharata going back, he tells Bharata, "By your sister-in-law and me, I swear, tumhari bhabhi ki kasam, meri kasam, don't shout at your mother." He doesn't even have the freedom of abuse. 14 years he can't even shout at his mother because Rama has sworn by himself and by Mother Sita. Why do I say this? So that we can lead a hateless life. A hateless life is a lovely life. After several years of ruling, Dhruva is being taken to heaven. As he's going, he says, "Where is my mother?" "Your mother? She goes before you to Vaikuntha." And that is how it is. When we have children who are virtuous, their parents reach Vaikuntha before them. Even today, Dhruva has the pole star position. Those who listen to Dhruva Charitra at the end of the day, they will have long life, good health, and freedom from sin, says the Bhagavata. We enter the fifth skanda. Bhagavata has 12 skandas. The fifth skanda is in prose. I hope you know that the style of the Ramayana is very simple. The style of the Bhagavata is very difficult. I'll give you a sample of the shlokas. How does the Valmiki Ramayana start? Tapasvadhyayiniratam, tapasviva vidambaram, naradam paribaprachya, Valmikir Manipungavam, Konvasvin Sampratam Loki, Gunavan Kacha Viryavan. Very simple. You see the Bhagavata, Yampravrajan Rupeta Pretikutyam, Vaipayano Virahatatar Ajuhav, Putreti Putreti Tanmayataya, Taravobinedu, Tam Sarva Bhutadvayam, Munimanatusmi, Nigamakalpataru Galitam, Palam Shukamukhat, Amritadrava Samyutam, Pivata Bhagavatam Rasamalayam, Mahurako Rasikaha, Bhuvi Bhavukaha. Total tongue twister. That is what the Bhagavata is. That is the poetic style of the Bhagavata. I read out to you the prose style of the Bhagavata. How difficult it is, you will know after I have read it. I tell people, don't read the Bhagavatam with the glasses of scholarship, but the glasses of humility, bhakti. That's the only way. Otherwise, how do you expect an English teacher to be a Bhagavat Karta? There was a king called Swayambhu Manu. He had one son called Uttanapada. Uttanapada's son was Dhruva, and Dhruva Vamsha is there. The other son was called Priyavrata. Priyavrata came to know that he should not get married, that he should not settle down in life, otherwise he'll be caught in the meshes of birth and rebirth. So he decided to take to a life of renunciation. How is that described? Yarhi vaha rajan sa rajaputraha priyavrataha paramabhagavataha naradasya charanopasevaya anjasa avagata paramartha satatvo brahma satrena jikshishyamanaha avunitala paripalanaya amnata pravara guna ganaikanta bhajanadaya स्वपित्र उपामन्त्रितो भगवति वासुदेव एव अव्यवधान समाधि योगेन समावेशित सकल कारक क्रियाकलापो नैवाभ्यनन्दत्यपि तत् अप्रत्यम्नातव्यं तत् अधिकरणः आत्मनः अन्यस्मात् असतोपि पराभवं अन्वीक्षमाणः.
वन सेंटेंस, हाउ डू लाइक इट? एक वाक्य है. दिस इज संस्कृत. Breathless eloquence.
You can't stop. There is no punctuation. There is no punctuation. If there is a full stop or comma, you can stop. Otherwise, you can't stop. That is the Sanskrit language. British schools are having Sanskrit as compulsory. Germany is having Sanskrit as compulsory. If you read Sanskrit and study Sanskrit, your breathing system improves. Your memory power improves. Children's capacity to learn science and mathematics improves. Here is Priyavrata who says, no, I don't want to marry. I don't want to settle down and get into the meshes of birth and rebirth. He is told, this is a compliment to you householders, a sannyasin who has no self-control is far inferior to a householder who has self-control. You are superior. That is why Yudhishthira is respected. That is why Harishchandra is respected. That is why Satyayana and Savitri are respected. Why? Because as a householder, you can be superior to a sannyasin if you are following your dharma. So he is married to a lady called Barishmati. He has a son called Agnidra. This fellow also goes off for tapasya. They bring him back, send a beautiful nymph to entice him, and he comes. He has a family. The first son is called Nabhi. 7 days you are listening to the Bhagavatam, or maybe 2 days you are listening to the Bhagavatam, you are saying Narayan, Narayan, Govinda, Govinda. You go to the temple, you say Govinda, Govinda. Going back to Bombay, Delhi, Calcutta, Bhagavan ko bhool jate hain. Kitni baar Thakur yaad aate hain? Aate nahi hain. Aate hain to theek hai, lekin nahi aate. You don't have that commitment to the Lord which you have in pilgrimages. Here is Nabhi asking the Lord, may I never forget you. May I never forget you. Whatever I am doing, kabhi bhoolo nahi aapko. This is what Nabhi is asking. Whatever I am doing, let me remember you. In one of my songs, I tell the Lord, main bhool nahi sakti.
Main bhool nahi sakti, tujhe bhula nahi sakti, ke tu hi data hai. Mera bhagya vidhata hai.
Nabhi has a son called Rishabhadeva. Rishabhadeva has several sons, and the eldest is known as Bharata. Because of him, our Jambudvipa came to be known as Bharata Desha.
Esham khalu mahayogi Bharato jeshta shreshta guna asit enedam varsham bharatamiti vyapadishanti.
We take our children for a picnic, and there also we play that fast music, dag 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 dag, and children are dancing. The dog is dancing, dada is dancing, dadi is dancing, and children are dancing. Why don't you take children into a beautiful atmosphere and teach them the values of life? Children coming back from school feel they are emancipated. Lagta hai koi release ho gaya. No, no. Make them feel happy where they are studying. The atmosphere should be beautiful. We had a trustee called Vinod Nivateji with us, with my brother. He would say, Didi, ek aisa school banao jahan har ek kamre mein 10 pankha lage. 10 fans in every classroom. I was teaching in Presidency College, which is 200 years old, with one fan which never worked. Sad. Nobody thinks of conditions for children to study. You should have conditions which are conducive to the best of learning. Here is Rishabhadeva taking his children into a beautiful atmosphere and telling them, children, this body was not for bhoga, it is for yoga. You don't have to go to school to learn sensuous delight, but to learn sadhana, you need a guru, you need tapasya. And he says, he is a guru who saves you from the fear of death. Any bondage in the world should save you from fear. That is a true bondage. Guru nasasyat, sajano nasasyat, pita nasasyat, janani nasasyat, daivam nasasyat, napatista sasyat, na mocheetyaha samupeta mrityum. He breathes his last, and Bharata becomes the next one to be studied. Bharata's history is an eye opener for us. Please don't mistake me. All of us love to have grandchildren. But the moment we have grandchildren, no puja, no Hanuman Chalisa, no Vishnu Sahasranamam. The Lord who gave you that baby should bless that baby. Make the child sit there. Vichvam, Mitnul, Vatat, Kalo, Bhuta, Bhavya, Bhavat, Prabhu. Let the child lisp the names of the Lord. You'll be happy. I feel very happy when children lisp the name of the Lord. Even if they mispronounce, Krishna likes it. Here was the great Bharata. So much devoted. Morning and evening, he was thinking of the Lord. In Sanskrit, let me tell you his condition. Evam karma vishuddhaya vishuddha sattvasya antarhraya akash sharire brahmani bhagavati vasudeve mahapurusha rupopalakshane srivatsa kaustubha vanamala ari gadadir upalakshiti nija purusha rillikitena atmani purusha rupena virochamanaha ucchaistaram bhaktihi anudanam edamanar ayajata. Every day is bhakti for Lord is going. Every day, Shankh, Chakra, Gada, Padma, Vanamala, Kaustubha, Pitambara, bracelets and anklets and crown and bejeweled earrings, all this he concentrated. One day came when he did not know whether it was morning or evening. He was dissolving in divinity, as I put it. Dissolving in divinity. Taya ittham avirata purusha parichagyaya bhagavati pravardhamana anuraga bharadruta rudaya shaitilya Parsha Vegena Atmani Udbidyamana Roma Pulaka Kulaka Outkantya Pravritta Pranaya Bhashpa Nirudhava Lokanayana Evam Nija Ramana Runacharana Ravinda Anudhyana Parichita Bhakti Yogena Pariprita Paramaklada Gambhira Rudaya Rudava Gada Vishanaha Tamapikriyamanam Bhagavatsa Paryamna Sasmar. How do you like the Sanskrit? High flown Sanskrit. It's like the Ganga, like the Niagara Falls. The Ganga flowing, the Bhagavata is telling us, he didn't remember whether it's morning or evening. Such a great man fell. Aapka aur hamara kya kehna? Suddenly we have moha. Moha is any attachment that detaches you from the Lord. It took 70 years for me to come to this conclusion. Any attachment that detaches you from the Lord. You have left your homes, your business, your office, your relatives and come here because you have conquered moha and you love mohana. Somewhere you have to conquer moha. Somewhere. That is why at the end of the Gita, Arjuna says, Nashto moha smritir labdha tvat prasadat mayachuta sthitosmi gata sandeha karishye vachanam tava. It took 18 chapters for Arjuna to say this. It will take 18 births for us to say Nashto moha. Here is our great man called Bharata going for a river bath. There he sees a pregnant deer. The deer comes to drink water. As she is about to drink water, she hears a lion's roar. She gets frightened. She turns around. In sheer fright, she delivers the baby. The little one is born. I hope you know, you and I have to take swimming classes. But animals can swim by instinct. So the little one starts swimming. The little deer is floating down the stream and our great man picks up the deer and holds it in his hand. The dear little deer, poshana palana lalana preenana. That is all. Four main occupations. Fondling it and bathing it and feeding it and putting it to sleep. My dear little deer, D-E-A-R and D-E-E-R, teacher of English, that's why. Dear little deer. The moment you have a moha for anything, you forget everything else. Everything else is forgotten.